Children, after the Second World War, so many incidents took place. Out of them, the Russian Revolution is also called as the Russian Socialist Revolution. Took place in Russia in 1917. It was the most important incident in the world history. Actually, in Russia, during the First World War, the Russian Revolution took place due to that revolution. So, Russia made an agreement with, made a treaty with the Germany and came out of the war. So, we have here, there are two revolutions are there in Russia in 1917. One is small revolution and other one is the big revolution. So, the first revolution, okay, in olden days, before the time of First World War, the Russia was ruled by the Tsars. What are the Tsars? Tsars means emperors. Who are the Tsars? Emperors, kings. Tsars ruled over the Russia. Russia was a vast country. It spread over the Europe and Asia. So it is called as the Euro-Asian power, and also it had the third largest populated country in the world. The main occupation in the Russia was the agriculture. Agriculture was the main occupation in the Russia. Even though they had the agriculture as the main occupation, the majority of the lands were in the hands of feudals means the landlords. So majority of the lands were in the hands of feudals, landlords, the small farmers and the common farmers. Generally, they had paid the rent for the land which they tilled. For using that lands, the small farmers paid the rent to the landlords, feudals. So this feudal system and capital system was there in the Russia. Actually, during the war, even though Russia is the largest army in the world before the First World War, but during the First World War, almost 2 million of army and common people died in that First World War. And also, large, huge amount of the food products were shifted to the war front. Due to that, shortage of the food was created in the country. The common people were unable to get the sufficient food in those times. And also, the Russian economy was declined. It was worst in the position. It was in the worst position. So, the people tired of the military activities and military action, and they are tired of the war. They were not in a position to continue the war because of lack of food, lack of bread. They eat the bread. And the prices rose up. So many economical disturbances were there. So in that situation, on March 8th, 1917, about 10,000 women demonstrated against the Tsar, demanding the peace and bread. What is peace? To stop the war. They wanted peace by stopping the war, and they want food for themselves. So their main demand is peace and bread. So by demanding peace and bread, the 10,000 women demonstrated. They held the dharnas. And due to that, the Tsar Nicholas II. Tsar Nicholas. Tsar Nicholas was irritated and ordered his army to suppress that rally, suppress that woman, even by firing at them. He ordered firing orders also. He gave the firing orders also. But the army did not do like that. And army also joined with them. And the workers joined with them. Within the 2 days, it became big demonstration. And the position in the Russia war became worst within the 2 days. So this was the first revolution. So due to that position, the Tsar was unable to maintain his position. So suddenly he escaped from the country. Why? So the first revolution was ended by the escaping of the Nicholas. This is the first revolution. It is March 8, 1917. Actually, the Russians, they followed the Julian calendar. What is that? Julian calendar. But overall the world, the people, they are following the Gregorian calendar. Gregorian calendar. We also following the Gregorian calendar. Until the 1918 January also, the Russian government also followed the Julian calendar. Actually, Gregorian calendar days, 13 days ahead of Julian calendar. So, actually, in Russian history, this revolution is called February Revolution. And this revolution is called October Revolution. But there is a difference in the Gregorian calendar and Julian calendar. 13 days difference is there. Due to that, according to our Gregorian calendar, this revolution took place in the March, even though they called it as the February Revolution, it is took place in the March, and this is in the took place in the November. So October Revolution, March Revolution. But according to Gregorian calendar, it is the March Revolution and November Revolution here. So finally, after the escaping of Nicholas, the liberalist and other persons formed a temporary government. They formed a temporary government. Okay, that government led by them. But that new government, that provincial government, temporary government, the provincial government wanted to continue the war. Why they decided to continue the war? To save the honor of Russia, to maintain the dignity of the Russia. And they expected they could win in the war. So they wanted to continue the war. But the people were tired. They were not in a position to continue. So the people demanded to put the end to the war. So the people were in the despair. They started to form like the groups. They formed in the councils. That groups were called councils. And again the councils were called as the Soviets. What are that? Soviets. Soviets means councils. What are that? Councils. Groups. Groups of people. They united in the Soviets or councils. The workers, Soviets, and the former Soviets. Like that, so many Soviets were formed. In the same time, the rural people in the Russia, the rural people in the Russia were united under the Communist Party of Russia. What is that? Communist Party. Communist Party of Russia. They are also called as the Bolsheviks. 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 The Communist Party of India, that was the major party based on the communism ideology, and they were also called as the Bolsheviks. They supported the Soviets. So under the leadership of Communist Party, the Soviets demanded the nationalization of factories, nationalization of banks, and redistribution of lands. Which land will be redistributed? From the landlords. They would take the lands from the landlords, and that land would be redistributed. That is the main demands of that Soviets. So the same demands are supported by the Communist Party of Russia. So automatically they got the support from the Soviets, and with the help of the Soviets, the Communist Party, the Bolsheviks, put the end to the provincial government. They had taken the power from the provincial government. They formed a new government under the leadership of Vladimir Lenin. He was the Bolshevik leader, Vladimir Lenin. Under his leadership, the provincial government was changed. Government was changed. And when they came to power, they started the steps to end the war. So made an agreement with Germany, and they put the end to the war, and they tried to establish a new type of economy, and they tried to rebuild the economy, and they redistributed the lands, and they nationalized banks and other things, factories. So almost they fulfilled the desires of the people. But of course, they had taken the power from the provincial government. They had taken the power from the provincial government. But the power did not transfer to the Bolshevik because of the civil war. The civil war broke out in Russia. What is that? Civil war. In the civil war, the White Army led by the monarchist who supported the kingdoms, the people, the monarchist and the anti-communist army also. The White Army, one is the White Army, and although the anti-communist army supported by the Britain, USA, France. The Britain, USA, France, of course, with the Russia, they worked together in the First World War, even though they were opposite to the ideology of communism. They were the capitalist countries. So they opposed that communism, spread of communism. So they supported the White Army and anti-communist army. Okay, finally, in 1920, the White Army and the anti-communist soldiers army were defeated by the Bolsheviks in 1920. So they got the complete power from the provincial government. The government was changed completely. Then they gave a chance to get the independence of some nations. But though most of the countries who were under the Tsar ruling before, they joined in USSR. USSR, what is that? The USSR was set up by the communist Bolshevik government of Russia. Communist government of Russia. That is the Soviet government of Russia also. Yeah. Okay, after death of Lenin, the new leader emerged. He was the Stalin. Is the Stalin? Stalin. Stalin was the powerful leader. He suppressed all his opposition. And he implemented economical reforms. So he tried to rebuild the economy of Russia. He started the planned economy. You know the 5 years plans in India. The 5 year plans were started first by Stalin in Russia in 1928. 5 year plans. 5 year plans in Russia were started by Stalin in 1928. So this is the economical reforms program. In this program, he had the two main factors. Two main programs were there. First one is the fast industrialization. What is that? Industrialization. Fast industrialization. And the second, collectivization of agriculture. So he concentrated on agriculture and industrialization. What is the collectivization of agriculture? The small lands were merged into large area, into large plots, and people together as a group, they have to cultivate that land. So that is the cultivation of, what is that? Collectivization of agriculture. So by collectivization, they got the so many benefits. What are the benefits of collectivization? You know, we can easily cultivate that land. We can get the irrigation, and by the mechanization of the agriculture sector, we get more profits from the collectivization of agriculture lands. So due to this collectivization of agriculture, they got good crops, and fast industrialization took place. These are the main things. So Stalin, when you get a question about the Stalin, after the death of Lenin, Stalin became the Bolshevik leader. He was a powerful leader. He suppressed his opposition and he implemented the planning economy. That is the 5 year plans introduced in 1928 by the Stalin. And also in his program, two important programs were this. First is the fast industrialization and the second is the collectivization of agriculture. So this is about the Stalin. Finally, Russia industrialized and modernized, and they tried to implement all the ideals of the revolutions. But some of the persons, due to that violence, they did not agree to the real equality and real liberty and real equality was not acquired by the people. So the famous writer George Orwell, he wrote a novel, Animal Farm. George Orwell wrote a novel, Animal Farm. In this novel, this is the satirical novel. In this novel, he explained how the ideals of Russian Revolution were suffered in the period of revolution. And in his opinion, Russian ideals of equality, liberty were not achieved. So he explained satirically in this Animal Farm. So you may get the questions. Who wrote the Animal Farm? George Orwell wrote the Animal Farm. Okay. After the Russian Revolution, so many countries inspired by the communism and socialism. And who wanted the equality and liberation, that countries tried to form the communist governments in their countries also. So Russia, USSR supported that type of countries. Supported the type of countries. And our India, in our India also, M.N. Roy, Rabindranath Tagore, Jawaharlal Nehru, they were the socialists and they inspired by the socialism, socialist revolution of Russia and communism of Russia. But even though they have not agreed the violence and the suppression, even though they did not agree the suppression or violence and the violation of the freedom in the Russian Revolution and the communism, they inspired by the communism. And so many countries became the communist countries in the future.